So we've got a iris transmitter receiver set here. So we're going to show how to set this up and align it on the press brake. So what we're going to need is a set of alignment plates for the transmitter receiver. There's two bags of hardware that come with the system. There's the mounting hardware for the alignment plate, and then you've got the nuts and washers for the transmitter receiver. 6mm Allen key, 10mm open-ended spanner, a set of alignment tools with the little locator tabs, and a set of punches for putting on the machine on the far left and right hand side of the machine so we can fix the alignment magnets. So with the alignment cards here, there's one for the transmitter end of the machine and one for the receiver end. And there's a magnetic strip on each one. So they can get onto the punch like that and align with the tooltip. Now in each kit they come with these little adhesive tabs. And what these are for sticking onto the alignment card just to make it easy to locate on the tool when you put them on the machine. So this one's already been stuck on. So you can just see here where it says tooltip, the little notch on the back just aligns with that tooltip mark. And this is the one for the other side of the machine. So this one here, you'll just stick it on where it says tooltip and stick that down. And then when you place that on the machine, you just sit the tool in a little groove and that's in the right position. So it's the set of cards. So first thing we're going to do is just set up these two alignment mounting plates. So in the first bag we've got the screw. You put the split washer on first, followed by the flat washer. It goes onto the bracket, and then the square nut goes on the back. Same for the other one. In the other bag, we've got the washers and the nuts for fixing the plate onto the transmitter and the receiver. So in here we've got two types. There's a standard nut and then there's a nylon locking nut. So what we do with we'll start with the transmitter. So we're going to put the standard nut goes on first. So just one on each post. Just screw them down close to the bottom. And then a flat washer. And then the plate with the screw pointing towards the front of the unit. And another washer, and now we're going to put the locking nut. So we're just going to tighten these up, and what you want to do is just tighten it up so it's maybe about 2mm of the screw going through the top of the nut. And just so they're even. Okay, just like that. And then we just tighten up the bottom nuts. So you just want to do these up firmly, not too tight. And just make sure as well on the back here where that slot is, just put it roughly in the middle to start with. Okay, we'll do the receiver. Okay, so that's done. Now the units are ready to go onto the machine. So we're going to put the transmitter onto the vertical bracket. So we're just going to loosen the nut at the back just enough so we can slide it into the slot on the vertical. So we'll slide that in, just get it roughly in the middle. And we're just going to tighten up this screw on the front. And when we tighten the screw, you don't want to over tighten it because it can jam up. It doesn't need to be too tight. So once the screw is firm, just probably just a half to a quarter turn, and that's enough to hold it in place. You don't need any more than that. After we've done that, we're going to connect the cable. So before we plug the M12 cable in, we just want to make sure that we've turned off the power to the system so we're not hot plugging it. That's done, and now we'll do the receiver side as well. So again, we just tighten that about a quarter turn, and that's not going to move now, that's in place. Now we connect the cable. Again, making sure the power is turned off before we plug that in. Okay, so now we're ready to start aligning the system. We need to put the alignment cards onto the upper tooling. So there are two cards here. One's for the left side of the machine and this one's for the right side of the machine. So we're just going to place it on the punch. So again, we just locate the tooltip on the tooltip mark. And if you've got the little locator tab stuck on the back, that just makes it easier. Just make sure the card is relatively level. And then we do the same on the other side. So the first adjustment we're going to make is to get the laser inside the box at this end. So we're going to adjust the vertical position of the bracket, just slide that down. So the laser is sitting inside that box, just lined up with that lower edge. And then we're going to adjust the plate. We'll just loosen that about a half a turn, slide that back a bit. So now just so the laser is sitting inside that red box now. So that's all good. So we're just going to tighten that up. Again, just make sure we don't over tighten the screw for the mounting plate. Okay, now we're going to do some fine adjustment to the transmitter to adjust the laser at the far end of the machine to make sure we get the laser parallel across the entire length of the machine. So you'll see here that there's a cutout in this card, and there's that little rectangle of laser that shines through. We want to align that rectangle of light with the black rectangle on the card at the far end of the machine. So to do these adjustments now, we're going to use the locking nuts on the posts to make the fine adjustments at the other end of the machine. So to adjust the height, we're going to make the adjustments at the back here, just loosening these nuts. We'll do that first, and then to adjust the front and back, we're going to loosen this front one and the back one. So this one at the back stays locked up the entire time. So you can see at the other end of the machine, the laser is a little bit low. We want to bring that up inside that black box. So when we're doing these adjustments, we just want to do small turns. We don't want to make it totally loose. So let's just tighten that one up on the front first. So I'll just say do a half or a quarter turn on the bottom, half a quarter turn on the top, same on the bottom, and just keep gradually adjusting it. It just gives you better control. And you can see at the other end, the laser's moving up towards the box. That's about right there. Now I have to adjust the front to back. So I'm just gonna loosen this bottom nut off just about a quarter turn. The back one, about a quarter turn. And just pivot that towards the back. That's inside the box, that's about right there. So now I can lock those nuts up. That's about right now. So after you've done that adjustment, I'm just going to come back to the left hand side and make sure that we're still inside the box. So sometimes when you make an adjustment, especially on a longer machine, you make the fine adjustment, but it's moved, the position is moved on the left side, so you might need to just readjust that. So we'll just check that, maybe just adjust that slightly. That's pretty good. Just lock that up. We'll just check the other side again. I need to just adjust that a little bit towards the back. So again, just a slight turn, just enough to loosen it. Small adjustment, and lock that nut up again. So that's pretty good. So that's the transmitter done. So after we've done that, we can remove the two alignment cards. Okay, so we've removed the two alignment cards. Now we just need to adjust the receiver. So this adjustment is fairly simple. So you can see the laser is there. It's aligned with our punch. So we just need to move the receiver so the light fills the receiver window. So the first thing is just to adjust the vertical position of the bracket. So just bring that down so the laser is inside the window, lock that up. Just adjust the slide plate if necessary. Okay, so once the laser is inside the window, just push the scan button on the side of the receiver and that receiver will now scan the tool. So the LEDs there indicate that this tool scan is in progress. Okay, so once it stops, if the light turns green, that means that the receiver has found the tooltip and is automatically aligned. So the system is now aligned and the machine's ready to operate. If you get one of these red lights coming on, but not the green light, that'll give you an indication of how to make the adjustment. So, for example, if I move the transmitter down a little bit, the receiver down a little bit. So the up arrow comes on, that means I have to move the receiver up. In this case, the down arrow comes on, it means I need to move down. Okay, the green light means that the alignment is complete. If it's misaligned front to back, you'll get the left and right arrows coming on. So the arrow pointing to the right means you need to move the receiver towards the back, so just slide that backwards. Arrow pointing to the left means I need to bring the receiver forward. We have the green light, means everything's aligned and it's ready. So after you've done that, just make sure everything's tightened up. Again, don't over tighten the screw. Just check all your nuts on those plate are tightened up. And the system's now ready to operate.